Hi everyone! Welcome to the VSDC channel. If you've watched our recent videos, you might have noticed that we often use shake transitions. So this time, we are going to show you how you can create these cool transitions and use them in your own videos. Let's start. First, we need to set up our project. Frame rate is the key here. We'll set the time frame parameter to 30 frames per second. This will allow us to have precision down to a single frame, which is crucial for replicating the effects exactly. But feel free to adjust the settings if you need something different. Let's create a sprite and select the set the same size as the parent has in its properties. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Brush? Transparent. Now, let's add two video files to the timeline. Our transition will be located on the layer above the video, not inside it. Then, let's create a sprite. Draw it in any shape and select the set the same size as the parent has in its properties to expand it to the size of the scene. Set the sprite's duration parameter to 1 second. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? Yes. Next, double-click the sprite. Inside, we will apply four effects: two motion blurs, zoom, and a lens distortion. Let's start with the motion blur. You can find it under Video Effects, Filters, Motion Blur. Set it from start of the scene for 13 frames. Adjust motion type to linear motion. Then, expand blur distances and set this parameter from 0 pixels to 20 pixels. Also, set the blur angle from 0 to 25 degrees. And finally, extend the boundaries, true. Great! Let's duplicate this effect and place its start at the end of the first one, stretching it to the end of the sprite. In this copy, invert all the values. Set blur distances from 20 to 0 and blur angle from 25 to 0. Next, let's add the zoom effect to the sprite. With time frame 13. We're going to adjust the first parameter levels and click on the three dots on the right of it. Then, in the key editor window, we add a keyframe at the 7th frame, setting it to 105%, and set the last keyframe to 135%. Duplicate this effect. In the duplicate, change the keyframes. The first to 135%, the second to 105%, and the third to 100%. After that, move the second key closer to the first. Select the sprite with the transition, change the sprite settings to Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Now back to the first zoom effect. We will animate the center parameters to create video movement. Click the three dots next to center X. We will select the Bezier curve mode to smooth out the movements. Move to the second frame and shift the zoom center. If the center isn't visible, click Show Hide Center in the Effect Properties. Move the center to the bottom left corner, automatically creating keyframes for X and Y axis. Then, move to the sixth frame and shift the center past the top right corner. For the ninth frame, move it back near the bottom left corner. For the 11th, move it to the top right, and for the 12th, sharply to the top left. Now, choose the second zoom effect and open the curve editor for the center X parameter. Change the type to Bezier curve and set the center to the top left corner at the first frame and to the center at the last frame. Select the sprite with the transition. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? Yes. Show effects? No. Now, let's create blur from the movement of the zoom center. For this, we will add another motion blur effect. This time, in the properties, choose zoom motion for the motion type parameter and animate blur distances from 0 to 15. Set the duration of the effect to 7 frames and align its end with the end of the first motion blur. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Next, we move to animate in the center. Click the three dots in the center X line. We will select the Bezier curve mode to smooth out the movements. At frame 0, place the center in the top right corner. At frame 2, in the bottom left corner. At frame 4, back in the top right. And at frame 7, in the top left. Duplicate this effect. And for the copy, set the duration to 10 frames. Go into the key editor for the center X parameter. Remove all keyframes and set the first keyframe to the top left corner and the last to the center. Almost done. Just the lens distortion effect is left. It is found in Video Effects, Transforms, Lens Distortion. Move its start to frame 5 and set the duration to 8 frames. Animate the distortion factor from 0 to 0.7. Duplicate the effect. Place it after the previous one and change the animation settings of the distortion factor from 0.5 to 0. Set the duration of this effect to 10 seconds and place it under the zoom effect on the timeline. And final touches. Set in a marker to know where the transition happens. Place the cursor at frame 13. Select the sprite with the transition and press the Create Marker button. Choose a color and click OK. Change the sprite settings to Uses container? Yes. Show effects? No. You can also add a transition sound inside the sprite. Your transition is now ready. You can save it in the templates library to use it in other projects. Open the templates window. Select the sprite on the timeline and click the plus button, name it, and your template is created. Now you can drag the transition into the timeline and place it over your videos. Feel free to experiment with the effect parameters and add new effects to create your unique transition that will enhance your videos. If you enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on video editing. Your support means a lot to us and helps us bring more content like this to you. Thanks for watching and keep creating! See you next time!